Now let's take a look at this example question. Here it says you place 50 mLs of 0.100 molar NaOH into a coffee cup calorimeter at 50 degrees Celsius and carefully add 75 mLs of 0.100 molar hydrochloric acid, also at 50 degrees Celsius. After stirring, the final temperature of the solution is 76.12 degrees Celsius. Heat capacity and the density of water are also given. Now from this, we have to calculate two parts. For part A, we have to figure out what is the heat or Q of the solution in joules. Since we're going to need room to do both of these questions, I'm going to take myself out of the image, guys, so we have more room to work with. Now, what we should realize is that we need to find the heat of the solution. The problem is it's hard to do it directly, but we can find the Q of the water. If we know Q of water, we can then say Q of water equals negative Q of the solution. Remember, in this process, the sample will undergo a chemical reaction and release heat. That's why it's negative. The water will absorb that heat. That's why it's positive. We can find the Q of water because we can say Q of water equals mCat. We already know the specific heat of water. I give it to you. I say it's 4.184 joules over degrees times Celsius. Our temperature change, our final temperature is 76.12 degrees Celsius. Our initial for both samples when we mix them together were 50 degrees Celsius. Now the harder part is just figuring out what the mass of the water is. But we can figure this out. Because when we say 50 mLs and 75 mLs, those two things actually represent the volume of water. What's really going on here is that we have that many milliliters of water, and dissolved within it are those moles of NaOH and HCl. So we're going to take those 50 mLs and that 75 mLs and add them together to give me 125 mLs of water. Since I know the density of water here, I can use that to find the grams of water. Okay, so multiply this times the density. mLs cancel out and I have 125 grams of water, which I can just plug into here. When I multiply everything out, that gives me 13,660.8 joules as the Q of water. So we can just plug it into here. So we're going to have 13,660.8 joules equals negative Q of solution. But I want Q of solution, not negative Q of solution. So then all you have to do is divide both sides by negative 1. So now Q of solution equals negative 13,660.8 joules as your final answer. Here we're not concerning ourselves with number of specific significant figures, because here we're just trying to figure out what the answer is. If you were to get this type of question on your exam, your professor would specify, do they want sig figs or not?